Welding flash burns can create intense eye pain, where a lot of the time it can be a delayed reaction, where people will go to bed feeling fine and then the eye pain will actually wake them up in the middle of the night. So why and how does this happen? And are there any home remedies or treatment that can help the eyes? Let's focus in. Flash burns actually have a bunch of different names. There's arc eye, welder's eye. Some eye terms is photokeratitis, UV keratitis, and it's actually the same thing as snow blindness. Now, as you can probably tell from the term UV keratitis, the damage is actually happening from UV light, ultraviolet light. Now, if you can see on this picture right here, the cornea is this nice, clear tissue, clear dome at the front of the eye, and this is where light usually passes through and gets focused to the back of the eye to allow us to see. Now, light between about 400 and 700 nanometers in wavelength gets passed through, gets transmitted. Below that, 400 nanometers to 10 nanometers, the corneal tissue actually absorbs that energy. And if it gets absorbed, and a lot of it, that's where the burn and damage happens. UV light, being high energy light, hits the epithelial layer of the cornea, the more outside layer of the cornea, and this is where the damage happens, and it also causes apoptosis, or cell death. So because the cells took in all that energy, it disrupts the function and eventually leads for those cells to die, maybe down the road a little bit, and eventually those cells will slough off. Now, because they slough off, it leaves the inner layers of the cornea exposed, including the nerve plexus. So pretty much when this happens, your eye just has open nerves exposed to the air and to your eyelid, and this is why people have intense pain and sometimes can be a delayed reaction to that intense pain. So common symptoms, one definitely a characteristic of photokeratitis is that delayed pain. Like I said, super common for people to wake up in the middle of the night with their eye in intense pain. Also photophobia, light sensitivity, foreign body sensations, super common for people to feel like there's sand in their eye, gravel in their eye. Maybe it feels like the back of their eyelid has something in it, maybe sand or something kind of scraping on the eye. It usually happens in both eyes. You can have one eye that seems worse than the other one, however. Can cause a lot of eye watering, redness, and blurry vision. Now, what do we usually see when this patient comes in? How does the eyeball look to us? Super common to see quite a bit of inflammation. The eyes are usually red, injected, have beefy blood vessels. Something also that's common is something called chemosis, where the top layer of the eyeball will actually become a little bit swollen. And probably the main thing that we're gonna do, we'll actually put some yellow sodium fluorescein dye in their eye. And this dye will actually stain or dye any damaged tissue of the eye. And if you look at this picture right here, this is actually a picture of someone with photokeratitis or a flash burn. And the highlighted green area, that is actually damaged tissue from the UV light. So pretty much that is where all the open nerves are that's causing all of this pain. This is called keratitis or punctate epithelial erosions. And the more staining that we have, the more green area over the cornea, the more severe the symptoms will be, especially if you have some of that staining right in the middle of the cornea over the pupil, then the worse the vision will be, then the more blur you'll have in your vision. Okay, a little change of scenery here. Now let's talk about healing and treatment. Now I do wanna say one bit of good news is that the eyes are actually really fast healers compared to other parts of the body. Usually photokeratitis can actually heal within 24 to 48 hours, sometimes longer depending on the severity, but it's usually pretty fast. So the name of the game for treatment is actually supportive care. So you're trying to reduce symptoms, maybe trying to help the eye heal faster or heal better. First line of treatment, and this is gonna probably be your best friend, and that is to use artificial tears, specifically preservative-free artificial tears. Artificial tears will provide comfort, moisture, reduce irritation, and if you use them frequently, it can actually sometimes speed up the heal time and make your eyes actually heal better. And because you're probably going to be using them a lot, this is why you want to stay with preservative-free. If you use eye drops a lot that have preservatives in there, those are usually the ones that have the bottle. The preservatives can actually irritate the eyes if you use it a lot. And yeah, you definitely don't want that. So if you stick with preservative free, you can actually use those eye drops quite a bit, every half an hour, every hour, every 2 hours, while your eye is healing up. And along the same lines, there are artificial gels and ointments that are thicker versions of artificial tears that you can use at nighttime, maybe to help you sleep a little bit better, coats the eye a little bit better and longer. You can also use it in the morning when maybe that's where it's mostly irritated, or throughout the day. Those are thicker drops, but yeah, you can use them kind of when the time is right. Now, one trick that a lot of people do is they'll actually take the artificial tears and put them in the refrigerator. So the eye drop is actually a little bit cold and cool on the eye, and actually that helps reduce inflammation and can sometimes actually feel even better. And number two on those same lines, you can actually use cold compresses, whether it's ice packs or cold washcloth. Putting them right over your eyes can reduce the inflammation, reduce swelling, and actually just make your eyes feel better. Now with the pain, you'll definitely want to check with your primary care doctor on this, but you can use oral pain medication, whether it's ibuprofen, Motrin, or Advil. And then definitely be wearing those sunglasses and bright lights if you are light sensitive. And then if you are a contact lens wearer, try and stay out of your contacts until this is completely resolved. Now, there are other home remedies that kind of have been thrown out and been out there for a while. Some of those might be grating a potato and putting it on your eyes, the tea bag on the eyes, the Vicks vapor rub below the eyelids. Sometimes some oils, almond oils, I've heard that you can rub on your eyelids and make your eyes feel better. All of these haven't really been shown to actually make your eyes heal faster, but there are a lot of people that say it definitely makes the eyes feel better. So you can try some of those, but I would stick with some of the remedies like the artificial tears, cool compresses. Start with those. Those will be your best friend because those can actually help your eyes feel better and possibly help heal faster. Now, like I said, this is self-limiting. Your eyes will heal. They'll heal great and fast. You'll be back to normal, but if you get a flash burn, I still would say go to your eye doctor to have them check. There are things that we look for to make sure that your eyes are going to heal properly and nothing bad is going to happen. So when you go to the eye doctor, they'll definitely put that yellow dye in there. Check the keratitis, check your cornea. If it definitely looks like it's more moderate or severe, sometimes they'll actually prescribe you an antibiotic, not necessarily meaning that you have an infection, but sometimes we want to be preventative. We want to give you an antibiotic, start you on that so you don't get an infection. When you have keratitis and if it's moderate or severe, that next layer of the cornea is exposed and it is at a higher risk of getting an infection. If you get an infection into the tissue of the cornea, then it gets a little bit more serious and starts getting a little bit sight threatening. And so sometimes we can just do that to be preventative about it. The other thing, if we do see enough inflammation, severe inflammation, your doctor might prescribe an anti-inflammatory eye drop or a steroid eye drop to reduce the inflammation and swelling. This can make the redness get better, irritation better, and overall the inflammation go down. So that is something your doctor might do depending on the severity and how it presents itself. So if you've ever had a flash burn, I'd be curious to hear what your home remedy was. What helped you the most? What helped your eyes feel better? If there was anything that we didn't discuss in this video, leave it in the comments. Let other people read them, help them out. I hope this video helped. Keep your eye protection on and stay focused.